So in the name of Almar Tuella, I am Tawseef Iqbal. Today we are going to discuss about different types of dosage form. So in previous lecture we have already discussed about definition of dosage form and oral dosage form. Dosage form which are liquid, especially syrup, mixture, emulsion and tincture. And solid dosage form that of tablet and capsules. So today we are going to discuss about one by one different type of dosage form. So first one, rectal preparations are rectal dosage form. So these include suppositories and enemas. So suppositories are solid dosage form, solid preparation for insertion into the rectum. Suppositories are solid dosage form, while enemas are liquid dosage form, liquid preparation for insertion into the rectum. Especially in constipation related cases, we all use enemas. Next is parenteral dosage form or parenteral preparations. Solution or suspension of drug that may be dispensed in, it may be through ampoules or vials. What is ampoules? Ampoules containing single dose. Basically, the container of ampoule are made from glass. There are different type of glasses. But pharmaceutical, I am talking here about pharmaceutical glass. So ampoule should be contain single dose. While vials are rubber capped bottle containing a number of doses. So parenteral preparation mostly we are giving through parenteral route. It may be intramuscular, intravenous, subcutaneous, intrathecal and many more routes. So as far as route is concerned, this is the part of next lecture. Next one is inhalational dosage form or inhalational preparations. So this include gases, volatile liquids, steam inhalation, and last one aerosols. So different type of the pharmaceutical dosage form. So gases are available in different type of pharmaceutical dosage form and they are administered through special devices just like in asthma or lung related diseases. So we are giving it through a different type of dosage form are given in the form of gases just like other ventilator through which we are administered to lungs, gases or other type of dosage form. Next one is volatile liquids, steam inhalation and aerosol. So what are aerosol? Aerosol released into the respiratory passages. Respiratory passages belongs to respiratory system in the form of a fine mist of liquid droplets. So atomizer are used, or we can say dosage form converted into a fine mist of liquid droplets and they then reach to their target site. Next one is topical. Topical mean those substances which are applied on the surfaces. So this include ointments, liniments, lotions, lozenges. Number fifth, eye, ear, nose drops, mouthwash and gargles, powders and last one vaginal douches. So first of all, what is ointments? Ointments are semi-solid greasy preparation for application to the skin, rectum and mucosa. The base is usually anhydrous and contain the medicament in solution or suspension. So from ointment we got the idea that these are semi-solid greasy preparation for application to the skin, to the derma. are rectum and mucosa. There are different type of mucosa. So ointment can be applied to mucosa. That may be nasal mucosa or rectal mucosa. The paste is usually anhydrous. The paste which used inside or in ointment must be anhydrous and contain the medicament, the active pharmaceutical ingredient in solution or suspension, and the medicament should be in the form of suspension or solution. Next one is liniments. Liniments are liquid or semi-solid preparation just like ointment. Ointment also semi-solid. Liniment also in the form of semi-solid. A consistence thinner than ointment. Ointment is compared to liniment viscous, but liniment is thinner as compared to ointments. Applied to the skin by friction. This is point you should be got it that liniments should be applied to the skin by friction. Note, not applied in broken or bruised skin because they produce irritation, they produce pain, we can say. So they should be applied only externally, or we can say that liniment should be applied to the outer part of the body, or they can use externally. Next one is lotions. Liniment and ointment are available in market in different form and different weight and brands. Next one is lotions. So lotions are aqueous suspension. Aqueous mean water containing, aqueous suspension intended to for application to the skin without rubbing. This point you should be noted that in some semi-solid preparation we apply it by rubbing, but in as far as lotion is concerned, so they should be applied to the skin without rubbing. Next one is lozenges. So lozenges is just like a solid dosage form, we can say, but tablet like formulation for slow dissolution in mouth, just like pulmonal lozenges. So lozenges are tablet like formulation for slow dissolution in mouth. Next one is ENT, air nose, eye, air nose drops. So these are drops are available in aqueous solution for local application. So for eye, air, nose drops, and these drops should be in aqueous solution and they are mostly applied locally. Next one is mouthwash or gargle. Number next, powders, and last one, vaginal douches. So aqueous solution with antiseptic or cleansing properties. So douches have a property of cleansing, or they have antiseptic properties. They kill microbes and germs. So thanks for your attention.